Hello and welcome to the Mirror of the Throne. Intersectionalism. What do I need with that? The idea is, it is essentially maybe a good idea, but in practice it often leads to anthropocentrism, the worst form of discrimination ever. Let me explain. Intersectionalism is an ideology that actually basically says that all forms of oppression are intermingled. It also believes in a kind of hierarchy of oppressing, and often it is very anthropocentric. A lot of intersectional vegans, by my experience, are more afraid to hurt somebody else's feelings than actually making a change and let those oppressed people stop their hypocrisy. It seems to me that a lot of them are, to be fair, to be realistic, are spending more time by attacking vegans who don't are interested in their own political agenda than they are actually spending time educating non-vegans about veganism, how are black, or how are women, how are don't get enough payments, and they are often afraid to be called things there are not. For example, sexist when they call some woman out for supporting the same kind of sexual abuse that she is against, probably when it is down to members of her own species. We're talking about the dairy industry. Well, dairy cows are artificial inseminated, which is a euphemism for raped. They put a metal bar, they put a hand into the anus of the cow, they go very deep in her anus and then inject her with bull sperm. I've done a video about that. If you want to know more details about that, screw up industry. And also if you want to see how they're forcefully masturbate bulls to get the sperm by meaning of electro ejaculation. And then we don't even talk about the stealing of their baby. No, people. I think it is time. That we, I mean you, primarily, are starting to look in the mirror. Intersectionals, you can be, and we can be, working together to make this world a better place if you are truly believe in equality instead of attacking people who don't worship on the altar of so ironically called humanity. And if you want to know why I say ironically, check out that video of me where I explain the definition of the word humans and in contrast with popular opinions. I hope I have proof enough in that video that our species isn't called human and human is or a sociopolitical word used to divide our species from other species, or second, it means oppressor. That's also one of the things. Or second, next to that, it can also mean that the creature is humane. But if you want to know the whole story about that, check out that video. Intersectionals, that I am a white man according to the standards of society, does not mean that I have necessarily more privilege than a white woman or a black woman. I have not so much money, I'm poor in comparison to probably a lot of you who criticize me because I'm white, born white. In some places of the world, actually white people are the ones who are discriminated. Look to Saudi Arabia or that kind of countries. The world does not move only around America. America is not the center of the universe. And black people are not always the victims. There are countries where there are the oppressor, and times in history where there were the oppressor. And if you want to debate me on that topic, if you are truly want, check first out my article about the Arab people that were exploiting and enslaving Indians and the white slave trade by the Greeks. Article I have put in the description below. And if you have read that and you still want to debate me on the topic, I am glad to debate you. I do any Sunday a Q&A. So if you want then to hang out with me and talk, maybe on the Discord, you are welcome. I'm not a big. And if you want to challenge me on my standpoint that and biocentric point of view is a far superior position than an anthropocentric point of view, in that anthropocentrism is the root of all hatred. Anthros meaning actually coming from the old Greek word for our species, which is in old English mankind. Before the 19th century, 18th-19th century, the words human and humane were used interchangeably, and blacks were not called humans, they were called submen. They were called beasts of burden also, and they were transported with the slave food animals of today, the pigs, the chickens, and the other animals on the transport ships. They did not have human rights, and human rights was for the humane man. And according to the law, only white people in the United States can be humane, and probably the same can be said for Arab men in the time of the Ottoman Empire. However, black. Yeah, and I agree, there are a lot of similarities between different kinds of discrimination. For example, if you are looking country specific, the animal agriculture industry comes from the Arabic world, and the first forms of animal agriculture, I mean, started around some 1200 years ago in the Middle East. 12,000 years ago in the Middle East, I mean. The first societies that started to use animals as commodities were also the first how decided to use each other as commodities, because the step from one animal to another animal is not so big. The victim is nothing to defend though, nothing more than the next victim. The victims are interchangeable. Like Hitler did proved when he did created Auschwitz after the idea of animal agriculture. If we want to have peace on this planet, we need to eliminate animal agriculture. Animal agriculture is the most bigoted industry on the planet because it does not only oppress animals and kill animals, but it also kills people in poor countries, and it gives PTSD to their workers. That I don't care so much about those workers, because they're in my eyes like the Nazi soldiers how did kill Jews. And I don't care about oppressors. I care about victims. And if they're wants to be seen as a good person, the slaughterhouse workers, fuck them, that they get in other businesses often less money. Morals are more important than money, people. And hang yourself if you're not getting enough money. I don't care about oppressors. I don't care about slaughterhouse workers more than I care about slave masters. Or about Jeffrey Dahmer. Or about any Red Army soldier of Stalin. My compassion is only there for their victims. My heart hurt enough for the victims. I cannot have it in my heart to have any sympathy for evil people. I hope you understand that. You intersectionalists. I have never agreed to be a human rights activist, even like I did say, human is a socio-political contract, or you are cannot say that you are a human if you are not vegan, because then it is interchangeable with being humane. And killing animals, even for economical reasons, is not humane. Like I did say, economics is no excuse for cruelty. That's what we should learn. One of the problems on this world is that people care more about this than they care about decency and respect and coming up for victims of oppressing. If we were living in a society where anybody stand up against systematic oppressors and systematic oppressing systems, and society where bullies did not come away with their despicable behavior, and where they actually have a backbone and don't go to do if they are hurt by their parents, going to hurt somebody else. You don't deserve any kindness if you are not willing to give this kindness to ones who have never harmed you in your whole life. That's my standpoint. And I defend my standpoints. Because I am properly right. And I... wants to debate you if you want, but come please up with statistics and with proof instead of emotional rhetorics about how you feel about some stuff. I'm not convinced by an adult. And if you want that people, if some people can stop with radicalizing people, maybe take the advice of Dr. Luther King. When Dr. Luther King was asked to stop Malcolm X radicalism, he did reply, don't ask me to stop excess radicalism. Radicalism will stop. Malcolm X will stop when racism stops. If people were capable of rushing talk, then they know that more outspoken activists like Joey Carbstrong, like Gary Yourofsky, me, people who say what needs to be said, stop when the oppressor stop. I stop wishing stuff like that hunters get shot in the head, and that people who wear fur are getting anally electrocuted. I stop wishing that farmers get raped because they are raping cows on the moment that they stop raping their victims. One struggle, one fight, animal liberation. Screw oppressors' rights. And what do my wishes actually mean? It's all my wishes. Just like you probably wish that somebody who is a rapist gets raped. I probably know that you are wish that people who hurt children get abused in the same certain way. Even you are maybe saying not. So, what's the problem? Why protecting the innocent in children and then violating and making fun of the exact same innocent in animals? It is hypocritical. Get over it. Stop focusing on what people say and focus on things they actually do. Words are empty. Actions are what matters. If some vegans say stuff you don't like, remember, I'm not gonna to rape people. I am not gonna to burn down the houses of farmers or breeders, like I prefer to call them. Or burn down vivisection laboratories. But those people are burning the bodies of animals in the vivisection laboratories. They put metal hats on the monkeys to fry their brains. In the pig industry, they castrate baby male piglets and cut off their testicles with a cuticle remover and cut off pieces of their teeth. Remember, we vegans are not the violent one. Even the ones that wish some things and sometimes maybe say things that shock you. You are the ones that pay for things. We vegans show you and say that you are doing. It's time to connect your morals that you deep inside in your heart have, even if you don't want to show them, and go vegan. Actions with words. It's time to evolve, make a plea and move forward. Stop being a hypocrite, baby. when darkness and light become one, the reality splinter away and the true become visible.